We have treated spectrum since we were able to start using it for about 130 years. We've been treating it, in this country at least, like land, like property, like a limited resource. Spectrum, though, is instantly reusable, and land is not. And this is the biggest, most critical failure of the spectrum as land metaphor that we have going on. What's the goal? Why do we want to regulate it in the first place?
You can have order.
Order over interference. So, like, the whole idea of regulation is to prevent interference. What does it take to be really, truly agile with spectrum? It takes flexibility, and it hasn't been until fairly recently that we've been able to inexpensively and quickly reconfigure a radio. We now have the ability to control almost every aspect of modulation. And it's not just actuation, which is, that's the action that you take on your environment or on the radio. We're now getting better and better at sensing. And as you intuitively know, if you can sense and you can actuate, then in between that can be intelligence. And that opens up a tremendous amount of power. And it lets us leave this metaphor behind and really use spectrum in an efficient way. Okay, so hey, our radios are now smarter. We have intelligence in our radios. They're cognitive, right? Let's just have the radio listen first, just like a human would, right? The way that we're supposed to behave when we're behaving well on the bands. Listen first, and if you don't hear anything, go ahead and transmit. If you put the smarts in the radio, what could possibly go wrong? Well, sure enough, there was some interference issues, and they tracked it down to devices where the firmware that listened first was disabled. So that's something that you have to confront, is that anything sufficiently complicated to do something cool is sufficiently complicated to fail. Okay, there has to be a better way. And DARPA wants us to help figure it out.
Much of Michelle's talk was about how things are kind of done now and how things are thought about in the past, like Guy and others. I'm going to tell you why it's gone. That will just be totally washed away in a tidal wave. The machine intelligence is in total, complete, absolutely total control of this. And I don't even teach it how to work. It does a thing called reinforcement machine learning. So what it does is I say, here's what I'd like for you to do. And here's how you reward yourself. It's a metric. It should be concerning to you, and I know it is to me, that our favorite modes stopped being invented and became widely used by 1940. That is a long time before we have a tidal wave sweep over amateur radio. The modern tidal wave that's swept over amateur radio is what is in every ham radio shack now besides a radio?
Computer.
That is the tidal wave that has swept over us, and it is going to bring us back to being technical innovators, and I'm going to, probably the leading edge. We are uniquely situated to being the leading edge in radio again, and I will get there. Okay, so here it is. This is the big deal. This is the insanity. What does this look like to you? It looks like a land map. That block is owned by light blue, whatever light blue is. And brown is that little block, whatever that is, that owns all the little brown blocks. So they can't change. And it's ridiculous what they have to do to change stuff. The innovation that we need in amateur radio will come about one way. The same way it did when all of us got in here and innovated. We were young. We were foolish. We were crazy. We did junk that people told us, you can't do that. And we went, oh, hell yeah, we can, and we're going to. Okay, that is how innovation was done in amateur radio. Young people who thought bigger than they should be allowed to think, then the thing that enabled them to do it, the thing that enabled them to do it was amateur radio's freedom. And it's the ultimate democratic assignment of frequencies in the world. The wireless companies, they are going to get spectrum. They are a behemoth. They are a steamroller. You have a radio, and you want to talk to a cell tower. Qualcomm solved this by having it weak if it was near the cell tower and strong if it was far away from the cell tower. But that kind of, that's self-limiting in the capacity. It would be better if everyone could be weak. What if everyone involved could be weak? And so if the total power by all the transmitters went way down, the channel capacity would go up. How in the world can we do that? That's called the DARPA Spectrum Collaboration Challenge. Do you think you could take 10 networks of 20 radios in the network, spread them all throughout a city, and you manually manage that? The answer is no. We have to turn it over to machines. So this is about training the machines. I'm going to award you for getting your data and also penalize you if you don't help somebody else. But now I want to take you on a journey into tomorrow. The human brain is able to recognize and interpret complex audio and imagery data with extremely low latency and a less than 20 hertz clock. My computer has under a 20 hertz clock, but it has trillions of computers in it. What signal is on being transmitted on the air? And let me tell you what the signal processing person taught this program. I just did. Absolutely nothing. It doesn't matter if it's on a crappy channel. It doesn't matter if it has, so long as it's above the Shannon limit, I can name the modulation. I can tell you what's being transmitted. I taught it nothing. It asked me questions and I answered them. Let me get to the bottom line. Here is radio 5 years from now. Some of you are going to hate this story, but I'm telling you, it is radio. I'm going to take these neural networks, and I'm going to have one, and Michelle's going to have one. And I'm going to tell my radio, I have a message I want to send Michelle. Please send it to her, and I'm going to walk away. And it is going to send stuff back and forth to Michelle. It's going to figure out what's the right frequency, what's the right mode, what's the right forward error correction, what's the right. It's going to design the radio on the fly from scratch, without a subject matter expert involved. The radio will be done by artificial intelligence from beginning to end. So the object is now not the radio. The object is the activity the radio now allows. You will be able to do optimal waveforms and transmission of data on any channel. Whatever you have available, it'll just figure it out. My receiver, her transmitter, my receiver will send the data back and forth to each other in the best way that it can figure out to do it. You will not recognize your world in 10 years. This is everything. I put one of these on the ground and one of these in a satellite. And I can adapt. I can have the thing adapt to the link as it finds it, no matter what the conditions are. If it's low on the horizon, it'll have a completely different radio. If it's going over the zenith, it'll have a completely different radio. If it has four satellites up that it can use, it'll try to use all four. If whatever it sees as a mechanism for conveying my data to you, it will automatically collaborate to get the data there.
I don't want to send a picture from me to you. That's not my desired result. My desired result is an interesting conversation.
Yeah.
So the idea then would be I might put in a piece of information that says, hey, I'm available for an interesting conversation, and then the radio would go find other people that had put the same thing.
That's
my CQ,
idea.
Right?
That's a great idea. So you've given it a different context than I would have given.
Right.
Because we have different motives. So your context is different from mine. The radio will address your context.
Yeah, that's kind of what I was addressing.
And it will collaborate with other radios to implement your context.
Because I think most old-time hams have a different view of what they want out of the radio than just getting data from point A to point B.
I get it. But so. I contend there is enough room for all of us.
Oh, there is. But
we're going to have to do something like this to interest kids.
I'm just trying to see how it's going to fit together.
And this is not the only thing. Look, there's all sorts of other stuff like this. We need to not limit what these kids can do with amateur radio. They are going to outdo us if we only allow them. We can't limit them. Because this is a fundamental paradigm shift. All of this stuff DARPA Spectrum Collaboration Challenge, this will force transmitter and receiver to be a part of all of this.
So this has both negative and positive aspects. And again, this will have to be run through regulation and policy. It has their policy and regulatory issue. And maybe this is the new Part 15 Wi-Fi. Maybe that's what will come out of it.
If they can't tell you're doing it, why do regulations matter?
That's a good question. This may ultimately wind up being the ultimate democratization of spectrum.